Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be doing a peacock feather. I have a friend that has a farm and she has peacocks there. She gave me some of her feathers so I could do my tutorial. Here's one. They're really pretty. So this will be our reference today. I don't have a reference photo. I could take a photo of it and then upload it to my website. I'll put a link in the description box so you guys can go to it and see it, but it's just a reference. We won't be doing it exactly. I'll go through our colors today. We have Phthalo Blue, Phthalo Green, Raw Umber, Primary Yellow, White, and we might use a Metallic Gold if you have it. You don't have to have that one. But I was going to put it for little accents in the feather. So get all your stuff and let's get started. Okay, so we're going to put the background on first. I'm using a pretty big Filbert. It's a 50, it's a number 50 by Simply Simons. You don't have to use a brush this big. I just like to use it for the background because it gets it on pretty quick. We will mix a little bit, we'll wet our brush and mix a little bit of the white and just a small bit of the Phthalo Green. And it'll be a really light color. You might want a little bit more white. More white color, and we'll do that as the background. You can spray paint your, or spray your canvas with water to make the paint go on smoother. And we'll just go up and down. And we just want a little color for the background. We don't want it to be too dark because we have these colors that are gonna be in the feather. And we don't want to take away from the colors in the feather, so we're just gonna do a nice light. It's almost like a wash. It's not really a lot of colors, just a wash. Some more. Okay. And if your brush gets a little dry, just dip it in water. You can get the size right now if you want to. I'll just all around. Get the sides. You won't have to worry about it later. You don't have to worry about mixing the right color. Can rinse your brush out now and we'll let that dry for about maybe about 10 minutes or so. So let my mine dry and we'll get back to it. So I think my canvas is dry now. I just want to look and see where I want to put this peacock feather is pretty big. And I think I want to position it something like this. So that's what we'll do. Do it like that. That looks pretty. So first I'll do the stem. I'm going to get a little bit of raw umber. Mix a little bit of white so it's not as dark. And I'll just put in the stem where I want it to go. If your brush is dry, just let it move a bit. You can also use your chalk if you're worried about getting a straight line. Imperfections, and then just getting a little bit more of the raw umber and white. We're just gonna put where the eye of the feather is gonna go, where all the pretty colors are. It's just like a round, almost oval type of shape. So this will get covered up with the other colors. Don't worry if it's not perfect. And there's a little bit of a shape inside, a little round shape inside. Just want to know where those colors are going to go. Mapping out where we want all these colors to go. Brush out. And the brush that I'm using, it's like a medium sized round. You can see that. These brushes, they're my mermaid brushes. They don't have like a number on them. You can just see kind of it's a round. It's a smaller round. And they're all in like an upward line. I'm gonna do some more sweets. I can tell that this one, a lot of
lot of the feather has like broken off. They're not as long as they used to be. You can kind of see that they're kind of short and broken. So I'm gonna embellish a little bit. So it'll be pretty. The thicker the line will be. So kind of try to keep like light pressure when you're doing these, because you don't want the feathers to be too thick. They're kind of wispy. You can do as many of these as you want. You don't have to do as many as I'm doing. You can do more than I'm doing. I think there's no right or wrong way to doing a certain number that you need to do. Mix in a little more of the raw umber on the light that is running out. Thank you. So you can rinse your brush out. A little bit of Phthalo Blue. It's a little bit of Umber in there, so it can be kind of dark. Almost that here. It's a very high kind of peacock. It's shaped kind of like an upside down bean. I'm just gonna put that in. Your brush out. Now we'll get a little bit of the Phthalo Green, mix a little bit of the Phthalo Blue with it for the next circle of color that goes right. Here, right around that little bean shape. I'm gonna mix a little white with that so it brightened up a little bit. It's a little too dark. Rinse your brush out, and we'll do the next little section, and that's going to be raw umber and lots of yellow. It'll make it like a goldish kind of color. Get your paintbrush and your water if it, mine is drying up a little bit on me, but rinse your brush out. We'll get some Phthalo Green. Mix it with a little bit of your yellow. Phthalo Green mixed with the yellow and a little bit of raw umber to tone it down a little bit.
out. And what we'll do a raw umber mixture with the yellow, but a lot less yellow this time. We want it to be brownish, we just don't want it to be that dark brown. And that goes on there. I think that first gold coat, that first mixture of the raw umber and yellow, I want to make it a little bit lighter so you can see the difference. I tried a little dark, so I'm going to go back over that to make it more gold. Brush out. And I think we'll start working on these little feathers. If you need to play and go ahead and go. Down here to the other feathers, and from what I can see on here, like, they're kind of brown, but you can see hints of a greenish color, a bluish color, and kind of like gold. We'll do the gold last, but for right now we'll just touch up each of the feathers with some of that phthalo green primary yellow and a little bit of raw umber on each of these. And it doesn't have to be a continuous line. It looks like it has like flecks of this color in it. That was phthalo green. Yeah, and yellow. It's just a little touch of raw umber. And remember, for these little feathers, you want to do like light pressure. So I'm just going to go over each one of these and put just a little color on.
on some of them I'm doing like I'm tracing the whole feather with the green. On some of them I'm breaking it up a little bit so you can just see little hints of the green on them. Extra brush out, and we're gonna do the same thing with the Phthalo Blue, and I'll mix a little bit of the Phthalo Green with it to give it like a turquoise color. It's like a Phthalo turquoise, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna touch little spots where that color can peek through. Don't worry about your lines being totally perfect, because these feathers aren't perfect. If you look at them, you'll see that they're not perfectly straight lines, they're not perfectly curved, they're just really random. You can do as much of that or as little of that as you want. There's really no wrong way to do it. I'm just adding a little bit of that mixture and that, make that green a little darker that we did earlier. pretty good. Up top where it's thicker, and I'm doing some of the feathers with just the phthalo blue and phthalo green mixture. Okay, rinse your brush out. We're gonna get some raw umber and a little bit of phthalo blue. Get like a dark color. And notice at the top of the stem it's really dark, and then it gets light as it gets down. It's lighter. As you get to the bottom, it makes a little bit more of the mixture with white. Down here at the bottom, it's a lot lighter. I'll go over that again to get it even lighter. Come in, brush out. Get some raw umber and mix with white. It'll be a little bit darker. Use up the feathers up top. The leaves extend into the eye of the feather. We'll get our yellow and raw umber mixture. I kind of went over some of that when I was doing those lines. I got away from it. I'll kind of fill those back in. But you can see the lines, but they're not super thick. We'll just go over all of these eye colors. We can show back up again. Green, phthalo blue, a little bit of white. for the very middle, that was Phthalo Blue. Ring was Phthalo Green with mixed with yellow and a little bit of raw umber. I'm gonna put a little bit of Phthalo Blue just around the, just to line the outer part of the eye there. There's some Phthalo Blue right there. All I did was wet my brush a little bit, dry it on my towel, and it's just water. There's no color on here, just leaning in a little bit. How's that look? Looks pretty good. Okay, and then for this last step, like you can keep going, you can keep adding colors, you can make the feather more bushy if you want. I'm gonna leave mine here. And then the last thing that I'm gonna do is get my metallic gold, or you can use like yellow mixed with white for this last step. But I'm gonna get my metallic gold. And I'm just going to put like little hints of color all over the feathers. And it makes it pop a little bit more gold. I always like using these metallic paints on things like this, or if you were to do like a mermaid tail or something like that. It just really makes it pop. Especially in the right lighting, it makes it, it looks really pretty. Okay, just do that all over. Little hints of gold. And it doesn't overpower the other colors that you put on. It's almost translucent over those other colors. So you can still see the blue and the green. And this is just like a shimmer over top of it. Still using really light pressure though. You don't want the gold to the lines to be too thick. Unless you do, then go ahead. Thicker up here because these are a little bit more bushy and I just want to put a little bit more gold up there. If you want to put a little bit of gold in the eye of the feather, you can too. Just a little hint there. Rinse your brush out. Whenever you're done with the gold, whenever you have as much gold as you want. And now we're going to take a lot of white with just a little tad bit of raw umber. And we're going to fix the stem a little bit because this should be a lot lighter. Down at the bottom and then it fades into the darker color up top. And even some of these stems have more of the lighter color in them. You can skip this if you like the way it looks, just leave it the way you have it. So, first lightly, fade it into the dark. Phthalo Green, yellow, and a lot of white. Just some little accents in here. Just gonna do a little in here. Okay. that's it. You can keep going, you can make the feathers thicker, thinner, you know, you can do whatever you want with that, but I think I'm good with mine. I like the way it looks. And that's all. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. You can also follow me on my other social media. All of the links will be in the description box. Bye.